Since President Donald Trump took office, talk of collusion and Russian meddling in the 2016 presidential election has dominated headlines.
Eyewitness News morning anchor Chris Langlois joins us now at the very real ways that Pennsylvanians like you may have been impacted by alleged Russian interference.
And Dick Candace, thanks for having me. We're leaving behind that national debate right now over Russian meddling, and tonight we focus directly on how northeastern and central Pennsylvania could have been affected. It all really starts with this, a federal indictment accusing a Russian group of using social media to illegally influence the way that you think and ultimately the way you vote.
There's no collusion. There's no collusion whatsoever.
The special counsel's probe is progressing in a very serious way.
Setting aside the politics of special counsel Robert Mueller's probe, what Pennsylvanians should pay attention to is his 40-page indictment of Russian individuals and companies. They were accused of interfering with the 2016 presidential election, and they reportedly did it right here in the Commonwealth. Alleged meddling that started from the second you woke up on the screen nearest you.
The first thing a lot of people will do will check their Facebook page and see what's going on in the election.
The group's use of social media is laid out in the document, and that's where Pennsylvania enters the picture. For example, using a two-pronged approach of advertisements and calls for action, on or about September 22nd of 2016, defendants and their co-conspirators created and purchased Facebook advertisements for a series of rallies they organized in Pennsylvania called Miners for Trump and scheduled for October 2nd, 2016.
I think it could sway public opinion big time because people who have never voted before will go on social media. And this past election in 2016 had a large group of people who were first-time voters.
The indictment says these illegal posts were designed to look like everyday Americans in our community, with false U.S. personas to organize and coordinate U.S. political rallies supporting then-candidate Trump in New York and Pennsylvania. The group specifically targeted purple swing states like Pennsylvania, hoping to spread discord.
We've become such a partisan country, and in a way, social media has exacerbated that problem. When the message took hold, it just went on and on.
But the social media impact goes beyond posts and political rallies. In the months leading up to the election, the defendants allegedly encouraged votes for third-party candidates. For example, days before the election, the group purchased an advertisement supporting the Green Party, saying, "Choose peace and vote Jill Stein. Trust me, it's not a wasted vote." Yonkai says that started a series of connections linking Stein and Russia.
To me, the dots with Jill Stein are there. But that had an impact because it kind of gave people permission to, in effect, say, yeah, I think, well, look, this said someplace that my vote shouldn't be wasted.
A Senate Select Committee on Intelligence requested documents from the Stein campaign after this picture surfaced of a dinner in Russia. It was celebrating the 10th anniversary of the RT television network. And in this photo, you see Stein, Russian President Vladimir Putin, and former National Security Advisor Michael Flynn gathered around a table. In Yonkai's mind, that picture showed Russia's interest in 2016 candidates.
Oh, big time. That does connect those dots. Yeah, definitely.
Ladies and gentlemen.
During a campaign stop at Wilkes University in September of 2016, Stein seemed to emphasize the now bogus posts.
In this election, you know, the two establishment candidates, not only are they the most disliked and untrusted, but even their own supporters do not particularly like them.
Stein has since denied any connections to the Kremlin, saying in a statement, "Our campaign has observed the highest standards of transparency and integrity in our interactions with foreign nationals." But as the investigation continues into the Green Party's alleged connections with Russia, the numbers show the importance of that third-party vote in the Keystone State. President Trump won Pennsylvania by about 44,000 votes. Stein garnered roughly 50,000 votes.
Now, it is important to note Pennsylvania officials say there's no evidence these Russian groups physically impacted the presidential election, so no votes were actually changed. But the question still remains, were they able to influence how you voted? And also, if you'd like to see whether there are any interactions you might have had with those posts specifically, we do have a link set up over at pahomepage.com, so you can go do that and find that out yourself.
It's interesting. I mean, I know a lot of, like, you know, big social media platforms like Facebook are going to make some changes, but I don't know. I just see this happening all over again in 2020.
And what's pretty interesting is you can't actually go back and see these posts right now because they've been suspended by Instagram, right, Twitter,
sure,
Facebook. So again, that link on pahomepage.com, a pretty good resource for that.
Okay, Chris, thank you. Appreciate staying
me
up late,
yeah,
tonight,
yeah,
with us.
See you tomorrow morning.
Yeah.